Yes, we can.
Very nice. So I will try to do bigger picture. Okay. Say me when we are ready. José Luis, hello.
Hi, Yuri.
So it is a pleasure to see so many friends and co-workers, Maria Zahava. Finally, Ludwig is here. It is a great honor for me. Professor Streit is there.
Hello, neighbor.
So, Dima, we have already time or not?
Yes, already. So, well, you can start. I think that everyone is here.
My talk today will have two parts. One part is on screen related with random time for Markov processes. And second part will be shorter, related to random time just in dynamical systems. So I will start with the following. So motivation for random time. Actually, we can say, it is written on screen, that recently we have quite a lot of applications of random time coming from different areas of mathematics and also application in finance and so on and so on. So, and here appear deep and difficult question, what is time? Somehow we have traditional in physics, Newton, absolute time, uniformly running and so on. And we use this time in mechanics, in classical mechanics. And this time is nothing but some additional variable for our evolution equations, what we have in mechanics. But from my general point of view, time is characteristic of evolution. If in your system you have not any evolution, any motion, any changes, time is absent. Time will not appear. Time appears together with evolution, which appear in your system. And here we may have in mind different particular models. For example, if you consider ecological model, say plant population. This plant population in mathematical language may be described as, in simplest cases, Markov process of birth and death type. So plants appear, disappear from population, but in realistic situation, we should have in mind that actually plant population will have influence of many, many parameters. Say, evolution of plants will depend on water, will depend on light, will depend on season, day and night, and several other parameters, clouds and so on. So in principle, primitive description of population evolution as birth and death process is not enough for realistic description. We should take into account influence of several parameters, and this influence definitely typically is random. We have two possibilities. One possibility is to consider parameters of our system, birth and death rate, say, random, random and probably dependent on time, but we put all information in our kernels, which describe birth and death intensities. Another possibility to accept concept that we will have random time in our system. And this random time will be not uniformly moving, but will have more complicated motion, yeah? Which will include information about random influences on our system. This is somehow not so surprising. Even long ago, Vernadsky, biologist, and he pointed that for biological systems, for life matter, we need another concept of time. So some kind of biological time, which is different from Newton time. It was 100 years ago, but until now, this concept of biological time is not very well understood. So another motivation is coming from diffusion in heterogeneous media, in amorphous media, and so on. What people observe in experiment, that in such media, diffusion, time evolution of particles will be subdiffusive, will be slower comparing with Brownian motion. It is experimental fact. It is not somehow fantasy, yeah? It is just experimental fact. And immediately people in physics understood that such behavior you can produce if you use random time, stable subordinators, what I will speak later. So it means that using random time, you can reproduce theoretically experimental results. But openly speaking, for me, it is not a satisfactory answer. Because if you reproduce result what you observe, it does mean that you understand physics of notion, yeah? Probably Ludwig will agree with me. And here I have citation, what I very like from Franz Kafka, about the following, that right understanding and wrong understanding are not completely, are not mutually exclusive, yeah? And I cannot say that if people in physics reproduce right experimental data, it means that they understood the process what we have. Probably not only random time, but maybe other possibilities is to have behavior what we know from experiment. So it means that random time from one hand side has motivation, from other hand side, we should understand that it is not unique possibility to modify our dynamics. Now, what is random time we suppose to use? Well-known example of random time is so-called subordinator. Subordinator is non-decreasing Levy process with independent stationary increments and so on. It means that this process has monotonic parts, not decreasing parts. Subordinator is completely characterized by Laplace transform, and phi capital here is Laplace exponent. This phi is all information what we have, what we need about subordinator. But subordinator as random time, if you use subordinator as random time in Markov process, if you substitute time by subordinate. It will be not so interesting case because we have again Markov process. Completely different situation if you consider so-called inverse subordinate. Inverse subordinate is just, formally speaking, is inverse function for subordinator, yeah? And for exact definition is here, it's just inverse function. What is absolutely principal moment? First of all, inverse subordinator is not Markov. Second, inverse subordinator has such very essential structure. Namely, if you have subordinator, it is jump process, yeah? Levy process, jump process. For inverse function, we have the following. Each jump of subordinator produce constant value of inverse subordinator, yeah? So it means that inverse subordinator looks typical trajectory, looks as the following. It monotonically growing, after say, stay constant for some random time, again growing, after stay, and so on. Why it is important? Important because effect of inverse subordinator. Such period of constant values of inverse subordinator corresponds to catch of some traps for particle, yeah? Particle go after stay without motion, some random time again go and so on. We should expect that it will produce some kind of friction for our process. Our Markov process will go slower comparing with our non-Markov process after time change, will go slower comparing with initial process, yeah? Do you understand this simple remark, yeah? So we should expect that we will have such trapping effect. In the case of classical diffusion, if you consider Brownian motion and inverse subordinator as random time, you will expect subdiffusive behavior, what we really have. Now, now we go to Markov case. If you have some Markov generator L, then we have Kolmogorov or Fokker-Planck-Kolmogorov equation, which describe evolution of some initial function psi, or it is the same that U zero XT is nothing but action of semigroup corresponding to generator on initial function psi. Now, we will consider following transformation. Why? I will explain a bit later. We will consider a transformation which is called subordination principle. I will discuss in detail. We take solution for Kolmogorov equation U zero and integrate with kernel GT tau for each T. It is density of inverse subordinator. It is function of tau. For each T, it is density of subordinator fixed at time T, marginal distribution of subordinator. Why we are interested in this transformation? Because it became clear, and I will discuss also later, that relation between two solutions are the following. From one hand side, solution U0 is usual definition of semigroup for Markov process. Now you have another process which is not Markov, but nevertheless, you can look to expectation and it will be just marginal distribution at fixed time t. and it will be our function u tx. And such functions are related through such subordination formula. It means that actually random time change by inverse subordinator in Markov process leads to simple transformation of solution to Kolmogorov equation. Even more, we can show that this transformed solution is again solution to some kind of Kolmogorov equation, but this equation we should call fractional Kolmogorov equation, because instead of normal derivative, what we have in Kolmogorov equation, we have some generalized fractional or convolution derivative, what I will describe also. And this give us extremely nice, in some sense trivial, but nice relation that random time change in Markov process, it is the same that shift from Kolmogorov equation with normal time derivative to fractional Kolmogorov equation. So we have two equivalent objects, random time change and fractional equation. That is main observation what we need in study of such effect. So, of course, it was understood at first for very concrete subordinators, for so-called inverse state subordinators, and probably Meyerschaer from Michigan State University. Unfortunately, he died recently. He was pioneering in this business, and Meyerschaer and several collaborators, they developed big theory of such processes, Markov processes, with time change by state subordination. It is very, very concrete case. After several people in mathematics, Kolotov, Leonenko, and so on, were working in this direction also. In physics, Mainardi, Taku, Metzler, a lot of works in physics about random time change by stable subordinators. And for general subordinators, we have essentially less information. And here we have our works with Kachubey and Da Silva, also Schilling, René Schilling from Dresden. By the way, it is another Schilling, it should be with C, because it is German Schilling, it is not British Schilling. So, what I would like to stress that inverse stable subordinators people like very much because it is in some sense solvable case. About inverse stable subordinators, corresponding densities and so on, you know everything what you like. Yeah? But I do not see special motivation why inverse state subordinators are more natural in physics or other applications than general subordinators. Of course, technically it is very nice case, but it is only technical motivation, but not intrinsic somehow motivation. Next. This I repeat. Okay. As we already pointed out that for time changed Markov process, if you look to such expectation, we will have function, and this function will be solution to fractional Kolmogorov equation with fractional derivative. And this fractional derivative corresponds to some kernel K, and is given by following formula. So some people call this derivative convolution derivative or differential convolution derivative. We will call generalized fractional derivative. So it's very concrete formula. For concrete kernel, we will have concrete operator. Not differential, not convolution, but mixture of them. Okay. Now, as I said, we will be interested in subordination, which gives relation where Gt is density of inverse subordinator. As concrete case, we may mention Caputo-Zerbashan fractional derivative of order alpha. Now, this is such convolutional derivative with fixed kernel. Yeah, kernel is of special particular form. It is classical Caputo derivative. So, as I said before, we are interested in such generalized derivatives. And it is important to understand which class of kernels here we can use and how they are related with inverse subordinators. Yeah, it is very concrete technical question. How we can construct kernel K from inverse subordinate. We have several examples of such operators. For example, Anatoly Kochubey introduced distributed order derivatives, which are mixture of kernels with some intensity mu alpha. How to characterize such kernels? We will use following characterization, which gives us finally a very good relation with subordinate. Namely, let us consider Laplace transform of this kernel, what we use for derivative. So it is usual Laplace transform, lambda is positive, yeah? So we will assume, just a moment, that this function K calligraphical belongs to still TS class, or that is the same function L lambda, L calligraphical, lambda times K lambda belongs to class of complete Bernstein function, yeah? We assume that we have such asymptotic behavior for function K lambda, for lambda goes to zero and lambda goes to infinity, and for L lambda also for lambda goes to infinity and to zero. Now, such class of complete Bernstein function is very big classic in analysis, yeah, very, Bernstein is, by the way, Ukrainian mathematician from Kharkiv originally, after he did move in St. Petersburg. So there is this very nice book by René Schilling, Zong and Vondráček about Bernstein function. And this is really classic in analysis. So, how we obtain alpha stable subordinator? For alpha stable subordinator, we have a function K lambda of the following form. It corresponds to Caputo-Zerbashan fractional derivative. And function K lambda satisfy all our assumptions. You have other subordinates, Hausen, Wörthausen. I should jump because I have only 1 hour usually for talk. And Dima probably will stop me before. So what is very essential relation? If I look to such exponential function. So by Bernstein's theorem, we have a representation for this exponent via Laplace transform of some measure nu tau. And now I can introduce kernel for each t kernel of tau as such, sorry, for such convolution with measure nu. This function gt tau is directly related with function k and with inverse subordinator also. And actually, probabilistic meaning of this function I will show in a second. And first of all, we have this kernel gt. We have some information about this kernel. You see, Laplace transform of this kernel in T, it is possible computed, has very particular form. It again is given via function K lambda, Laplace transform of kernel, and double Laplace transform is also known. And important for each T, this kernel GT tau is probability density that will be clear from other motivation below. Now, what is probabilistic? What is probabilistic relation? If you have subordinate, this Laplace transform is classical form, phi lambda is Levy exponent, or phi lambda is lambda chi lambda. That is the same, yeah? So, and for function phi lambda for Levy exponent, we have representation where this is Levy-Hinchin formula, yeah? Classical result from probability. So appear measure sigma, and measure sigma in some sense is the same as that phi, because phi is represented by measure sigma, and from measure sigma you construct phi. So, and now our kernel in fractional derivative is nothing but value of this measure on half axis from t to infinity. So it means that kernel k small is directly constructed by inverse subordinator, by subordinator. Subordinator give exponent. This exponent represented by Levy-Hinchin, and from measure sigma, we have our jump, our kernel in fractional derivative, yeah? And we have, of course, such nice formula, which is relation between measure sigma and phi lambda. Now, we, as I discussed already, we have inverse, we have initial Kolmogorov equation and fractional Kolmogorov equation. And our aim to understand what is the effect of random time in terms of evolution, yeah? In terms of a solution to evolutional equation. If I know something about solution u zero, u not, then my equation, what I can say about solution u xt. So very important, because finally, what we would like to understand? We would like to understand how we can change asymptotic of evolution of states, because U0 XT describe evolution of state in our Markov system. How I can change evolution using random time? Of course, key relation is here. It is so-called subordination formula. And you can think that because you have this formula, you have no problem at all. Unfortunately, situation is a bit more complicated. Namely, of course, if you have enough information about this density of inverse subordinator, this probabilistic density, then you can discuss asymptotic behavior of corresponding entail. Say, if you know that U0 decay exponentially, what's about decaying of new function in time and so on. Main problem here is the following. Unfortunately, for general subordinator, our information about density is very small. As I said before, we have information about Laplace transform and T, Laplace transform and two variables, but except of random stable subordinator, we have no precise information, no formula for density. And it is main technical problem what we meet in our considerations. And for a long time, we spent quite a lot of exercises trying to have more information, and doesn't work. But after we decide to do the following, we can try to change study of asymptotic of solution to study of Cesare mean for this solution. Of course, it is not the same, yeah, but it is at least some information what you may try produce. So now Cesare mean is defined as usually via this integration with normalization. And looking to our subordination formula, we understood that actually asymptotic of solution will be deeply related with asymptotic of Cesare mean for density. And of course, depends on behavior of U0. But we understood that crucial moment here is Cesare mean for density. And it was a bit surprising for me that for density, we have not much information, but for Cesare mean of density, we can apply Tauberian theorem. Because absent any monotonicity of GT, we cannot apply Tauberian theorem directly. But this integral from zero to T is monotonic function. So I can apply Tauberian theorem. And it became effective. We described some class of what we call admissible kernel. Kernels will satisfy such two properties, such two asymptotic properties. For all kernels, what we discussed before, they are satisfied this property without problem. And such kernels we call admissible kernels. So Now we have such general result. If you are interested in Cesaro mean for density, you can compare Cesaro mean for density with Cesaro mean for kernel. And it became true that if you have such information about your function k lambda for lambda goes to zero, then actually Cesaro mean for density and Cesaro mean for kernel k coincide, yeah, they asymptotically are equivalent. Or in other terminology, it means that I look time. In other terminology, it means that Cesaro mean for density of inverse subordinator, it is the same as Cesaro mean asymptotically for our kernel K. That is somehow crucial moment for all applications. Now, we consider three examples. We consider admissible kernels such that they have three different asymptotics at zero. In one case, it is just asymptotic lambda in power theta minus one, similar to inverse stable subordinator, but it is only asymptotic. It is not equality as for inverse stable subordinator. Another class when we have asymptotic similar to one over lambda, and where we have function Lx of such form, and more complicated when we have another asymptotic for function F. Three classes of admissible kernel. And question is, what about asymptotic solution for such inverse subordinators? Now we have long list of cases, yeah? If you have just such asymptotic, then we can apply Karamata-Taubrand theorem to function k, integral 0 to t. It gives us following asymptotic for Cesaro mean. Another similar result for second class, similar result for third class, I will not discuss in details. If you look to particular model, and if we have assumed that our solution to Kolmogorov equation has exponential decay in tau, then we look to Cesaro mean for subordinated function, and we will have the following asymptotic for Cesaro mean. Inverse power t in power minus theta instead of exponential for class C1, another asymptotic one over logarithm for class C2, and another asymptotic for class C3. So, but you need a priori information about exponential decay. If you have not, you cannot apply this technique. If you have heat equation, then solution to heat equation for L1 initial condition will have not exponential decay, will have only polynomial decay, power d over two. What it means? It means that if you will apply our result about Cesaro mean, it will work only for G behaviorally called 3, because only in such a case U0 will be integrated. Yeah. In dimension 1 and 2, you have asymptotic of Cesaro mean, but you have not existence of integral. Yeah. So it means that for dimension 1 and 2, this method give not us possibility to discuss asymptotic. Okay. Next. The same approach we use for so-called non-local diffusion. Yeah. This non-local diffusion operator appear in several models of statistical physics. Yeah. It corresponds to, instead of diffusion, corresponds to compound Poisson process or random walk process. Yeah. And in such a case, if you assume some property of kernel A in terms of Fourier transform, asymptotically for psi goes to zero, then you have bound for evolution, for solution to Kolmogorov equation. And again, it will give you answer for dimension 3 or more. Only for this case, you have integrability of function, yeah? In dimension 1 and 2, again, it will not work. Okay. Now, very, very briefly about dimension 1 and 2. Here, we cannot apply this general method. So we will go other way around. We will consider Laplace transform of our solution. Laplace transform of our solution is the following concrete function. And now for each particular class, you should look to Laplace transform, asymptotic, and Tauberian theorem. So it means that using Tauberian theorem, you will have such and such, but again, for higher dimension. For higher dimension. If you will now, if you have not exponential decay, if you're not integrability, then Tauberian theorem will give you the following. For different dimension now, for d equal 1 and d equal 2, you will have different asymptotics. For dimension 1, you will have asymptotic not t in power minus theta, as in three-dimensional case or more. You will have another polynomial decay, theta over 2. So it is drastical difference between one-dimensional and three-dimensional case. The same for d equal 2. You will have another asymptotic, not t in power minus theta, but here will be also some logarithm. Yeah. So here we can consider a lot of particular cases. Probably you will be tired by formula. I only would like to mention the following. A lot of cases, particular cases, and so on. You can look in my talk in detail. I would like to say something about possibility to have asymptotic without Cesaro for general subordinator. Consider so-called relaxation equation in physics, yeah? The simplest equation of such form. And fractional relaxation equation after random time change with fractional derivative. Initial relaxation equation has well-known exponential solution, exponentially decaying solution. And equation, what about subordination of this concrete exponential solution, yeah? Concrete exponential solution. Answer, without Cesaro mean precise answer, but for this concrete function is the following. If you know asymptotic of your function Kp, then p in power minus gamma for some gamma between zero and one, and q is slowly varying function, then solution will have such polynomial behavior, will be polynomially slowly decaying, yeah? Instead of exponential decay, you will have only slow decay, yeah? Okay? Here we can consider particular cases, but it is the end of first part of my talk. Do you have any question for this part? If not, I will go to.
Thank you, Yuri. Thank you.
It is not everything.
This is not, yes, I see, I understand.
Only first part of my talk. Just a moment.
I have a question.
Yeah.
How the density G to T is related to the subordinator?
How density is related to the subordinator? I have again formula, I will show you. We should go back.
Because I didn't get it that, I didn't.
I should show formula, yeah?
Yes, I think so, yes.
Just a second. So, situation is the following. You have subordinator S.
Yes.
Subordinator S has Laplace transform. In Laplace transform, you have Levy exponent, yeah? Some function, which is belongs to Wood class of Bernstein function and so on. This function phi has such representation, yeah? Here appear measure C. Measure C may give you kernel, yeah? Measure C may give you kernel. And when you have kernel, you have corresponding.
I see. Yes. Thank you.
Convolution with this kernel.
Yes. Thank you.
Okay. Now I try to show another. Slide, just a moment.
Io lo, cioè questo è lo schema che c'ha lei, no?
I'm quite stupid. Allora, just do you see now?
Yeah.
So, the second part of my talk is related with another application of random time. Namely, uh, this we discussed already, motivation for random time. In Markov case, we know already everything. But now, if I have not Markov process, but just dynamical system. Each dynamical system is also Markov process. In stupid sense, it is deterministic Markov process. Yeah? And because it is again evolution equation of first order and so on, it is again Markov process, but with very different generators, we will see. So it means that it is very natural idea to apply previous consideration, random time change, to dynamical system, not to Markov process, just to dynamical system. So if you have a dynamical system starting from point X, it is also Markov process in stupid sense. And we can consider such function UTX similar to definition for Markov process, yeah? But without expectation. You don't need expectation, deterministic. This is also Kolmogorov equation, but more easy somehow because we have not random evolution. This equation in theory of dynamical system is called Liouville equation. Yeah, the Liouville equation in classical sense, and in this Liouville equation again is evolutional equation, and operator A in the right hand side of this equation is Liouville operator, yeah? So it is absolutely classical, nothing from me, yeah? It is absolutely classical. Now, simplest. What is the question? It is not to me?
No, go on, Yuri, it's just, yeah? I muted the.
You have some visitor? You see, consider concrete dynamical systems of this differential form, yeah? So V is vector field. So, and this is evolution in RG trajectory, yeah? And derivative in time is vector field and point XT. So it is absolutely one of the most important examples of dynamical systems, yeah? Liouville operator in this situation is nothing but first order operator, yeah? First order differential operator of this concrete form. And actually it is difficult moment for us that instead of parabolic equation as we have for diffusion, we have hyperbolic equation, yeah? And study of solution to this equation, from one hand side, it is simpler operator, first order. From other side, properties of corresponding evolution, much less attractive, much less easy, comparing with diffusion equations, yeah? So, Liouville equation for this dynamical system is the following equation, yeah? This is our Liouville operator. And this equation is extremely famous in application, the so-called transport equation. We have a lot of works and reviews and great people were working with such equation. And until now, I cannot say that we know everything about such equation, especially if vector field V is not so regular, yeah? It is quite difficult and open problem. Now, what we will to do? We will do the following. We will take again random time and substitute this random time in trajectory of our dynamical system. So we will have, because we substitute random time, it became a random trajectory, yeah? And again, we are interested in corresponding evolution equation. If we look now to similar object as before, but now we need expectation because why is random process? And similar to Markov case, we will have again evolution equation, again some Liouville equation, but we should call this fractional Liouville equation with fractional derivative, yeah? But nevertheless, the same subordination formula will work as in Markov case. And again, our problem how to estimate influence of random time on the solution. It is not a trivial question because solution for dynamical system may be very different comparing with Markov case. Say if you have transport equation, then solution to transport equation will have not the same asymptotic properties as for diffusion, yeah? It will be very different. And it means that from one hand side, we have situation similar to Markov, but technically it will be absolutely new and with new problems which appear here. We can look trivial example. Trivial example, if you have such evolution equation with constant vector field, yeah? So corresponding dynamics is just well-known formula from physics, yeah? It is uniform evolution with constant velocity. And if you have initial function exponentially decaying, then solution to corresponding Liouville equation is such exponential function in time. Say we start from zero. Then for class of inverse subordinator, what we discussed already, we will have the following. Instead of exponential decay, you will have only polynomial decay. In principle, very slow if gamma is close to one. So this example is, it is another open question for me. In the case of Markov process, we define so-called potentials or Green measures, as in last talk of José Luis da Silva last week. Question, if we can define, can introduce concept of potential for dynamical system. Formally, it is the following option, but actually I don't know answer for any class of dynamical systems about existence of potential. It looks that in theory of dynamical system, nobody discusses this question. So what else we can discuss? We can discuss asymptotic behavior of trajectories of dynamical system after random time change. Namely, if I have inverse subordinator, I have trajectory X, I put random time in this trajectory and consider solution to fractional Liouville equation. We have subordination formula, it was before, but now I will take special function f, just fx equal x. It means that I have subordination after expectation, I will have subordination of trajectory itself, yeah? Subordination of trajectory. And again, if we will consider example one, we will have the following. We will have the following instead of polynomial growth of trajectory, we will have much slower growth, but not proportional to t, but t in power one minus half. So again, for this dynamical system, random time produce some friction. And last moment, what I would like to discuss, which is also essentially open. There is natural attempt to obtain dynamical system deterministic from random dynamical system, from diffusion. Namely, if you consider such stochastic differential equation with small diffusion here, then generator of this diffusion is, this is not precise, should be epsilon squared divided by two, but it is not essential at all. Small parameter in Laplacian, yeah? So it is very nice parabolic equation, corresponding evolution equation, parabolic is elliptic operator. For each epsilon positive, no problem about existence and so on. We can consider this stochastic process as small perturbation of dynamical system without Wiener process, yeah? And question is, what about convergence of stochastic process to deterministic dynamical system? It was discussed in several books by Freidlin, Wenzel, Kutayans, and so on. But what we need, typically, we need very good condition on drift. V is called drift in stochastic equation. Should be uniformly Lipschitz and so on. And what is equation? How obtain solution to transport equation from heat type equation, from equation of Kolmogorov equation with small diffusion for non-trivial class of drifts, for non-trivial class of V. This problem now we study with my Italian colleagues, Luca da Persio from Verona, PhD students of Luca. And I hope that it will work, but in principle, it is general non-trivial equation. And I would like to say that, of course, this approach to transport equation is related with concept of viscosity solution, which is very important notion for such type of evolution equation. Okay, I finish finally.
Thank you very much, Yuri. Any questions, dear colleagues? Yuri, I have my standard question. What would happen in a discrete case? If we have kernels in the discrete case, we have kernels which are Mittag-Loeffler functions.
Yeah. I cannot say something concrete. Definitely, it will be not simpler. Actually, it will be a bit different situation. Stas Molchanov from this university discuss discrete cases, yeah, but not for random time. No, definitely, Dima, definitely it is absolutely right question. And you may expect different behavior. I don't know. Mm-hmm. I never did book in this direction. But for you, it is absolutely natural.
Yeah, question. Thank you. Okay.
May I ask something?
Okay, Mark, you are. Let you be the first because you are close to Yuri on my screen. Okay.
You see, you showed some formulas for processes with stochastic time, that there is effectively some friction and there is a conversion according to the power law. And you have power. Now, I will talk next time, and this is what I'm doing. It's an investigation of discrete fractional system. And I see it on many examples whenever I try that convergence to, it's normal that for nonlinear systems, convergence of fractional differential equations occurs to fixed point or periodic point, but it always occurs according to the power law with power. If it is, for example, equation of the order alpha, difference equation, fractional difference, order alpha between zero and one, it will be a convergence according to t to the power one minus alpha.
Yeah.
And but there are no, in fractional dynamics, there are no strict proofs. Would it be possible somehow to combine your approach, which you say equivalent to fractional, to get strict results on power law conversions in fractional dynamics?
Yeah, I believe that if you are working with classical fractional derivatives of order alpha, Caputo derivative.
Yeah. It doesn't matter. It's the same thing for Caputo.
It is definitely true. And moreover, I believe that it is well known from works.
No proofs.
Yeah, I don't know. I believe that it is easy and it is possible to do. If you like, we can discuss separately. More precise question, But for fractional derivative of order alpha, life is nice and easy. But my attempt is to understand situation with unusual fractional derivatives. And moreover, it's usually—
What do you mean unusual?
Unusual, which is not Caputo derivative, but general convolution derivative.
I will talk about general convolution derivatives, and this is true for general.
But I understood that you say alpha derivative,
Of the order alpha. What do you mean general? There could be distributed derivatives.
You see, if you have Caputo derivative of order alpha, this 1,025 papers in physics about this situation, or 26, I don't remember. But if you have not classical derivatives, which introduced by Kochubei, Toaldo, and other people, situation is completely different. It is not of order alpha. We have no concept of order of derivative.
Mm-hmm. But it's convolution.
Yeah, convolution derivative. And this convolution derivative may be very exotic. And as usually in physics, we try to understand pathology. Yeah. Which derivative will produce absolutely unusual behavior. This is direction in what we try to work. Today we have three classes of derivatives for which we have good asymptotic. But of course, we have another example which we do not able to analyze until now. Yeah, but we are very interested to see other. Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much. Jamal,
may I ask something?
Yeah.
Yes. If I understand right, you said that we can use this type of time to simulate systems with parameters that are not that are random,
mm-hmm.
right? In the beginning of your talk. So, if there are many parameters, would this procedure goes to any to every parameter of this one? How this kind of time is related to this parameters? If you can say something about this. Maybe your microphone is muted.
Yuri, you are muted. Yuri.
Is it Pierre?
Yeah. No, it's okay.
It is a very delicate question. In simplest situation, if I will consider very easy evolution, like contact modeling continuum, what we study with Lena Zizh and other colleagues, with Skorohod, we may include randomness in two ways. One way we can include randomness in parameters, say random mortality, depending on environment and so on. And we can include random in time, random time. We will have two models. And what is clear for this concrete model, that two such possibilities will give us different behavior. I cannot say what is more right or less right. Yeah, it is two possibilities to take into account randomness. Take randomness in time on randomness in parameters of your system. It is my answer. You. It is what you asked or not.
Thank you, Elena.
Yeah. May I ask questions? A question. Yeah. Thank you. So my question is about the first part of talk of Yuri about the result of by Anatoly Kochubey.
Yeah.
You consider mixture of alpha stable subordinator. You mentioned. And do you know the asymptotics of the corresponding right function, nu zero and infinity? I know that then maybe we can calculate asymptotics of the fundamental solution in this case.
I think so. Tolya Kochubey, who is now with us, may answer this question. Tolya?
Yes. Please, a little more specific.
My question, about asymptotics of the corresponding right function.
What function you mean? Is it a solution of a heat type equation for this situation or what?
This function, this function is a part of the, we use this function when calculate the asymptotics of the fundamental solution.
Well, I can only refer to my paper of 2008. And there is written everything I know about this distributed order case. I just don't remember
exactly. Can I ask you to send me this paper? Maybe.
Okay. No problem.
Maybe then I look, because it is nice if we can calculate all together this asymptotics of the fundamental solution for this non-trivial fractional derivative, not for alpha stable, but for mixture of alpha stable. It is interesting.
There's also, I remember some people in Poland working also in this direction. I remember the name Kubica, Adam Kubica, maybe. If I find, I will send you the reference.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Any other questions?
I have a question.
Yeah.
In the second part of your talk, the function f can be chosen as we like it.
Again, I don't.
Efimia, could you please ask again? I mean, just
the function f in the ordinary differential equations. The function f.
This one, yeah.
Yes, can be chosen as we like it.
Question is. This function f corresponds to initial data in Liouville equation, yeah? And this initial data may be compactly supported or just bounded or polynomially growing, different classes, yeah? For which you're able to analyze solution, yeah? So in principle, I should consider different classes of function f. It is
from
not
the data, really... from the data.
Yeah.
From the data.
F, initial data in Liouville equation.
Thank you.
And initial data may be very, very different, yeah, depending on model.
Thank you. Okay, so, well, okay, any other questions? If we have no questions, let us congratulate Yuri with a nice talks, two talks. It's very interesting, so which represents actually the whole scope of papers prepared during the past pandemic year, as I understand.
Yeah.
Was very interesting, impressive, and instructive. Thank you so much. If I would have questions, I would know to whom I would write it. Thank you. Next time we have talk of Mark about general derivative, fractional derivative, and dynamics based on these general derivatives. So, I will send. Maybe a clap. Okay, so I will just send out to everyone the program. And please, if someone want to make a talk, you're more than welcome. I enjoy so much your company on Friday. So you just always make my day. And I hope that in these difficult times, we can support each other. At least speaking to each other and asking questions and working together. Thank you so much,
Dima,
my dear friends.
Yep. A question. May we invite somebody else to listen if I want some?
Indeed. That's what we can do. I mean, just please, if you have somebody, I mean, be interested. I also send from time to time emails to my friends asking them to come. Well, so if you would do the same, I would greatly appreciate. Okay, thank you so much.
I would like to say thanks a lot for your attention, participating.
Thank you. So, well, have a nice weekend. Stay healthy.
You too, Dima.
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye.